Pisces rising September 2024 shows that you are drawing boundaries, standing firm, and choosing deliberate maturity for yourself and having a more cohesive kind of direction with your identity and the decisions that you're making. So if you are excited to dive into what we can expect this September for you based on your rising sign, make sure that you like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you are always up to date with what the stars have in store for you. If you're new here, hi, I'm Erin. I make videos on astrology and also music, so if you want to check out my readings or courses and anything else astrology I offer or my music, check that all down in the description below. So we'll start out by looking at what the astrology has in store, then we'll pull a tarot card and see how that all comes together. So we start out on the 2nd with a new moon in your Virgo 7th house of committed relationships. This does show a new partnership, new commitment, new contract, or new like committed relationship starting with someone that you're already close to. However, this new moon has a lot of blockages, delays, and roadblocks with it. So whatever new beginning in a relationship is starting at the beginning of this month, it doesn't look like the easiest or the most affectionate or fun. Then on the 2nd to the 4th, Mars in your Gemini 4th house of family is squaring Neptune in your 11th house of networking or friends. Looks like you are confused about what to do with your home or family because of people that you're connected to. They are being confusing, deluding you, or misleading you with living situation or family stuff. On the 4th, then Mars will enter your Cancer 5th house of dating and creativity, which shows that for the rest of this month, where you're putting the most effort and having to work through the most challenges is probably with dating someone or creative, maybe even partying-based decisions, something that needs to be resolved and you're working really hard. On the 6th to the 7th, Mercury in your Leo 6th house isn't squaring Uranus in your Taurus 3rd house. This shows that you're probably gonna have a discussion in the first few days of this month with people that you work with that is going to be chaotic, involving work and communication, like literally things you need to get done or announce or be productive with. People that you work with, it's a chaotic discussion. It could also be this random, could involve someone that you work out with or are like involved athletically or at the gym with. It can show that. So then on the 7th to the 8th, the sun in your Virgo 7th house is opposite Saturn in your first house. Looks like there's a lot of focus on a relationship this month, but you are having boundaries, you are being kind of cold, and you are drawing the line and standing firm on a situation between you two. You are definitely being the cold, mature, kind of closed off one. On the 14th to the 15th, however, Venus in your 8th house is trying Jupiter in your 4th house, showing that family and finances are going together really well. Either you are getting financially, you know, funded by your family, or perhaps you are investing in property and that is going really, really well. You're making money connected to family and home. Then on the 17th, there's a full moon in your Pisces 1st house. This shows an ending or a letting go of something within yourself that you are now feeling is delusional, immature, or not realistic, and you are choosing something more mature, serious, and aligned within your identity. And this could be something like physical body, or it could be with your character. On the 22nd, the sun then enters your Libra 8th house, showing more focus on finance and investing in October. And on the 22nd to the 23rd, Venus in that 8th house is squaring Pluto in your 11th house. You could feel as if a group of people that you're friends with is pressuring you to make a financial decision in a certain way that you really don't like and you don't want to necessarily do, but you're confused and unclear. On the 23rd, Venus then enters your Scorpio 9th house. So as we end the month and head into October, travel and education is actually going to be doing really well, and it could be a good time to either travel or your studies are going really well if you're in school. And finally, we end the month on the 29th to the 30th with Mars in your 5th house trying Saturn in your 1st house. So you're working really hard on something either in a romantic relationship or creatively and artistically, something, you know, art. You are really, really killing it. You are being mature, grounded, and that is the redeeming part of this month. If you already have any thoughts, feelings, or predictions for this month in your life, leave me a comment down below. I would love to hear how you're feeling and what you're expecting. Tarot card that we have here for Pisces risings this September is the Lover's Reverse. This generally shows a breakup or just coldness and not getting along with the other party. So this is a rather solo month of choosing yourself and drawing boundaries. I hope that you enjoyed this and that you have a cute September. It's a little bit of a rough, all over the place month, but we're gonna get through it and see how that all manifests and happens. So if you have any comments for me, leave them down below. Otherwise, like, subscribe, do all the things. It does help. I appreciate it, and I will see you in the next one.